Tonight we're having a special discussion on the country preparedness when it comes to COVID-19. What are some of the measures other counties have taken in terms of containing this disease, where the cases have gotten even much, much bigger, having reported 45 cases as of today. We're having Dr. Andrew Mulwa, the CEC for Health in Makueni County, of course, to elaborate what are some of the measures that are being done so far. Welcome, Daktari.
Thank you very much. Irene, okay,
can you tell us what are some of the measures, given that you're the chairperson of the CEC of Health in all of the 47 counties, the committee, what are some of the measures that the counties have taken in terms of combating and containing COVID-19, which is a disease that is unprecedented?
Irene, I must say what the counties have done and where we are as a country has been a concerted effort, multi-agency, multi-sectoral in approach, involving the national government, led by His Excellency the President, and the National Security Council, then the National Emergency Response Committee, led by, chaired by the CS Health, Honorable Mutai Kagwe. Mm-hmm. We also have the county structures, the Council of Governors represented at the National Emergency Response Committee, then the County Emergency Response Committees, co-chaired by the governors and the county commissioners. I would say the approach to how we combat this disease has been a one government approach.
Right.
And that's why I want to say, one, we have seen a lot of success in terms of how we've managed the number of cases, and like people have been saying, flattening the curve, which essentially means slowing the spread of the disease, which essentially we have been able to manage as of today. I think we have 535 cases that are confirmed. It had been projected by WHO and other international agencies, including our own epidemiologists, that by this time we would have over 10,000 cases in Kenya, meaning the strategies that have been laid out have been working.
Right.
And therefore, the whole point that I'm trying to drive home is our strategy number one is primary prevention.
Yeah.
Prevent the disease before it spreads.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we have made, as a government, both national and county, pronouncements and directives that limit social gatherings, that limit, that enhance physical and social distancing between people, cessation of movement from hotspots, in terms of Mombasa, Kilifi, Kwale, Nairobi, and Mandera, so ancient, and that is what we are doing, working to ensure that we prevent the disease before it spreads.
All right.
And the county government have been working with the national government to implement the directives that are issued at national level. They are working with the enforcement teams, both the national government and county government, to ensure that the directives that have been issued are adhered to. We have also been able to, as county governments across the 47 counties, to be able to prepare in case we get a case. And the counties that have had cases, thinking about the five counties that I've mentioned of Mombasa, Kilifi, Kwale, Nairobi, Mandera, Nakuru has also had a case. Migori currently has a case. Kitui have had a case. These counties have been able to efficiently and effectively been able to manage the cases on their own. That is the readiness that I would say all counties are ready. That in terms of having isolation facilities, having quarantine facilities, having the PPEs for healthcare workers, having trained healthcare workers, is our interventions that counties have employed towards response to this disease.
Okay, talking about response, the spread of the disease is fast escalating. And so far, Makueni County government has not reported a single case. As the CEC for Health in Makueni counties, what are some of the measures that you are taking in order to ensure that the disease does not get into Makueni County and you get to combat the spread of the disease in that particular county?
Just like I mentioned in the other counties, our strategy number one is on primary prevention.
Right.
In primary prevention, we are first trained or sensitized our community leaders, our communities, our heads of households on what COVID-19 is through local radio, through social media, through house-to-house movement, using our national government agencies in the village elders, the Nyumba Kumis, using the county government structures, the county development committee structures for public participation, the community health volunteers. We have also engaged our health workers to train and sensitize. And as a matter of fact, we have reached out to training in terms of absolute numbers to about 48,000 persons, community persons who we have been able to directly link, reach, and train in small groups of 5 to 10, so that they ensure that in terms of issues of hand washing, issues of hand hygiene, issues of respiratory hygiene, we have been able to reach out to them. Supporting our communities to and the vulnerable to have masks whenever they are moving out of their households.
Right.
We have engaged our youth polytechnics to manufacture, to make face masks for our people.
Right.
We have so far engaged them to make 150,000 face masks, which will be distributed to the vulnerable people living with disability, people living in extreme poverty, households that are child-led households, people who live in informal settlements are going to be the beneficiaries of this face mask, which we have started distributing through the county emergency response committee and its structures, which are the sub-county emergency emergency response committees and even the ward or divisional emergency response committees as the agents that we are going to use to ensure that door-to-door distribution of this mask. So we have also undertaken surveillance and we are doing screening along the busy Nairobi-Mombasa highway. You are aware Makueni serves about 174 kilometers of the Nairobi-Mombasa highway, and the truck drivers pose a risk because they are moving from counties and countries that are already have already registered cases.
Yeah.
We are doing screening on the highway at Mtitwande, and also another screening on our border with Kitui, which is really to make sure that if there are people who have symptoms of COVID-19, we are able to get them before the disease spreads to our community. Our through the trainings that I mentioned and further cascading from household to household education, our people are on very high alert. Every time anyone is visiting from Nairobi or any of the hotspot counties, we are able to get information from our citizens. And I think the critical thing that we have done is empowerment of the citizen so that they know what COVID-19 is, how to mitigate its spread, and how to be on the alert. I don't want to say Makueni County is very lucky, because it's a question of time. This is started in one part of China and has spread to literally every territory in the world.
Yeah.
And therefore, we would say for the best that we can do is to, as much as possible, slow down the spread.
Yeah.
And slowing down the spread are the measures that we are taking to just slow down the disease. The disease will eventually come, but we don't want to have numbers that we are unable to manage as the healthcare system of Makueni and of Kenya, like we have seen in some parts of Europe and America.
Of course, health is a devolved function, but can you tell us maybe some of the concerted efforts that you have had between the national government so as to enhance the containing of this particular disease? Is the national government coming in any way to help Makueni County government?
I think I would say, like I said earlier, the approach that we are using is a one government approach. That both at county level, I mentioned about the committees with the county commissioner, committees at sub-county level with the deputy county commissioners, and committees at the ward or divisional level with the SECs, assistant county commissioners. We also have at national level, the Council of Governors is represented in the National Emergency Response Committee. The chair of Health Committee of Council of Governors, His Excellency Governor Kuti, sits in the National Emergency Response Committee. I myself, as the chair of CECs, sits in the National Task Force on COVID-19, which advises the National Emergency Response Committee on technical issues on this disease. And therefore, we are involved, we are working, we consult, we literally make all the decisions together between the two levels of government.
Right.
In terms of support, I would not want to qualify in terms of support, because we are getting technical support. In terms of training our people, the national government came in a big way to ensure that we have some critical number of trainers who can be able to. They also helped us in terms of quantification, in terms of the materials, the facilities that you require, given the epidemiologic projections that had been given for the cases that we are going to have. We have had the national government also facilitate the whole cascade of testing, both training the people who are involved in testing. Still, we are using the national laboratories for testing. So once we collect the samples, we send them to Nairobi, KEMRI, a national influenza lab. And we have seen expansion of these labs from two labs in the beginning to now about 10 labs in the country that are able to test for COVID-19. So we have also seen the national government come in terms of mobilizing resources, donations, the Jack Ma donation, which was able to give us PPE. We have also, as a county, received sanitizers for every county through both the COG and through the county commissioner. So we would say we have continued to receive some support. Of course, I know we have not received all the support that we would have wished, but I think I would say, considering that this is a disease and none of us, even at the highest level, would have imagined that by May 5th, 2020, the whole world would be in the state that is in today. So I want to say, despite the challenges that there have been, we have been working cordially with the national government and working together to ensure that this pandemic is managed in the country.
Let's talk about the health workers. The health workers have complained both from the national and the county government that they are not receiving enough support in terms of being given the protective gears when handling the patients when it comes to COVID-19. In Makueni County, of course, you've not reported any case so far, but have you checked into the demands that are being given by the health workers so far, given that they have threatened that they will strike?
First, I would like to say PPEs are not an option. PPEs are a must. I'm a doctor by profession, and therefore, no healthcare worker, no person should be able to get exposed to disease without proper protection.
Yeah.
I think basics of medical practice is the clinician, the healthcare worker, safety comes before even saving life. The first thing that anyone in medical practice should ensure that they do is to ensure that they are safe, and it is only once they are safe that they should think about protecting or saving another life, because there is no need of protecting saving one life and losing yourself in the process, and therefore means many other people who would have wanted to be saved by you, you are not available for them.
Yeah.
So I want to start by saying PPEs are not an option.
Mm-hmm.
PPEs are not for counties that have registered cases.
Mm-hmm.
That's the second thing that I want to say.
Mm-hmm.
Every healthcare person, every healthcare worker who is in the clinical space,
yeah,
whether a cleaner,
mm-hmm,
whether a sweeper,
mm-hmm,
or the highest consultant, needs PPEs to be protected, because you never know whether the next patient that you are seeing in the outpatient with a simple headache, patient,
yeah,
who has a broken toe, patient who has any complaint, a skin disease, could be the person who is the first positive case in Makueni. And therefore, we have ensured that our healthcare workers have at least medical or surgical masks every time they are working in their facilities.
Mm-hmm.
And this, I want to say, is not a matter of if we can provide or we should provide.
Mm-hmm.
It is for every healthcare worker who is seen patient, whether for cleaning or for whatever reason, must be protected.
Mm-hmm.
And we have ensured that we have the PPEs. Of course, we have challenges in terms of erratic supplies. The,
yeah,
global supply chain,
mm-hmm,
has been disrupted in a big way,
mm-hmm,
by the COVID-19.
Yeah.
The prices of some of these PPEs has skyrocketed.
Mm-hmm.
Items have increased in price between 30 and 50 times in the last 2 months. And these are challenges that we are facing. We don't have all the money, but we at least can promise that we have enough to ensure the safety of our healthcare workers.
Mm-hmm.
We have had cases that are suspected in Makueni.
Mm-hmm.
We have managed about 35 suspected cases in Makueni,
mm-hmm,
and have had to take samples from,
mm-hmm,
nine. And therefore, we have required use of PPEs even here in Makueni in,
right,
terms of those suspected cases. You,
mm-hmm,
have to isolate them,
mm-hmm,
because you treat them as cases. You have to isolate, you have the clinicians, the healthcare workers must be on the full kit PPEs. We don't have all the PPE kits that we require, but we have enough to ensure that every person who is involved in the front line is protected.
We have had the complaint of faulty kits. Of course, Tanzania President John Magufuli has complained that some of the kits that were brought in the country through the JAKMA donation, some were faulty. Given that you are the chairperson and a member of the National Task Force and the chairperson of the CECs in all the 47 counties, have you received that particular complaint of having faulty testing kits?
I would not talk much because I don't work in the laboratory in terms of as county governments, because we don't have a laboratory in Makueni that is doing the actual testing.
Mm.
But in terms of the kits that we received for sample collection, for example, we have not had any problem with that.
Mm-hmm.
I have had that conversation about Tanzania, which I would like to say there are quality control mechanisms in every country.
Right.
I want to believe Kenya has a Kenya Bureau of Statistics, Kenya Bureau of Standards,
mm-hmm,
and also the Pharmacy and Poison Board,
mm-hmm,
and also professional organizations like Kenya Medical Association, which are represented in these bodies. We should be able to test the quality of every product that enters this country,
right,
whether it's a donation or an import or a purchase that has been done.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, I want to believe we have no reason to worry, because,
mm-hmm,
we have institutions that have the capacity do quality control of all the items that come. I would also have a problem with the approach that I saw, and this is purely my personal opinion and is not necessarily representative of the opinion of the government or the institution that I represent.
Right.
That for scientific tests are scientific, and there are scientific protocols,
mm-hmm,
on sample collection, sample storage, sample. So if you must test the specificity of a test, it can only be through having done the right sample, collected the right sample, collected in the right manner, transported in the right media, transported in the right temperature, stored send food, the same processes, the protocols that have been set for that test. Mm-hmm. If you don't follow those, or you get samples from other animals or other organisms, they may give you false negatives or positives.
Right.
There is always an established specificity mm-hmm. of every test and right. sensitivity of every test.
Mm-hmm.
So testing positive for a sample that is not the right one mm-hmm. does not mean anything in science. So I would say that, and you know, the opinion of the Republic or the organization that I represent, that right. is Makueni County right. or the CEC's caucus.
All right. Finally, could you tell us, given that you're a medical doctor, looking at how the country is handling the COVID-19 situation, and the numbers continue to escalate, now we stand at 535. Do you think the government is doing enough in terms of combating the disease, some of the measures that have been taken by the government, including the resumption of duties in the restaurants? Do you think the government is doing enough as it is?
I would say is really a balancing act. People have to balance between livelihoods and between the disease. It would be unpalatable to Kenyans to have 535 cases of disease, of which close to 200 are recovered without any treatment, and we have lost 24 lives, and we have 1,000 or 10,000 people die of hunger and starvation.
Right.
So I think it's a balancing act that any responsible government needs to do. And I want to say, because I began by saying, the projections had been done that by this time we would have over 10,000 cases.
Yeah.
We have done extremely well mm-hmm. as a government, and the government has done extremely well. What we are seeing now is what we call sporadic community spread.
Right.
There are hotspots within Nairobi and within Mombasa and Mandera of community spread. We have taken measures to contain the disease within these hotspots.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, as a health professional, it is the most important thing is, how do we contain the disease? Because this is a disease that we know is spread in clusters. So if it's Nairobi, there is cessation of movement in Nairobi. If it is some parts of Nairobi, I think the government would not hesitate to go into certain estates and say there is a lockdown in this estate. Because we also have to balance between the other essentials. We are not a first world country where people have savings that they can last them for months.
Mm.
In Kenya and in most of the third world countries in Africa, people have to work and only have savings that would last them probably for a month or even under. And therefore, one has to be careful as you think about extreme lockdown measures, that you don't kill more people from starvation than from the disease.
All right. Okay, Dr. We are pressed on time. Kindly, what can be your final words, of course, as we fight this pandemic, not only to the people of Makueni, but to the nation at large?
I would like to tell my fellow Kenyans that first, all of us deserve a pat in the back. We have done well together. It's time to celebrate the milestone that the spread has not been as much as had been anticipated. We have been able to flatten the curve. I know a lot of us feel fatigued, feel tired, feel that this has been too much. We are not yet there. The disease is going to be with us probably for the next 1-2 months, and therefore Kenyans should persevere, should follow the directives that have been issued by government, and be patient as the world normalizes.
Right.
Our better days will come back. Our fun will come back. It is time for us to persevere and let the disease pass.
All right. Thanks so much, Dr. Andrew Mulwa, for making time. That has been Dr. Andrew Mulwa, the CEC for Health and a member of the National Task Force when it comes to combating COVID-19 in Kenya, him saying that we will overcome the disease. We just have to be patient and persevere at this particular moment. We are taking a short break, but once we return, we'll be returning with more from the global sector. Stay with us.